Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Many of Jesus' disciples who were listening said, "This saying is hard. Who can accept it?" Jesus knew that the disciples were murmuring, and he said to them, "Does this shock you? What if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life, while the flesh is of no avail. The words I have spoken to you are spirit and life. But there are some of you who do not believe." Jesus knew from the beginning the ones who would not believe and the very one who would betray him. And so he said, "For this reason I have told you, no one can come to me unless it is granted him by my Father." As a result of this, many of his disciples returned to their former way of life and no longer accompanied him. Jesus then asked the 12, "Do you also want to leave?" Simon Peter answered, "Master, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and are convinced that you are the Holy One of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There's a wonderful new book out called Our Towns. It is a chronicle of 25 communities throughout the United States, from Columbus, Ohio being the largest, to a small town of 1,400 people in northern Maine, all of whom have completely reinvented themselves. Every one of these communities had fallen apart at the core. Many of them were originally manufacturing communities, and then the manufacturing left, the downtown began to deteriorate, and it was occupied largely by the homeless and the mentally ill. People who could afford to fled to the suburbs, and only the poor and the marginalized remained in the inner cities. Does it sound familiar? Erie is one of the chapters in that book. But when you read the book at the ingenious ways these people thought outside the box and reinvented their communities, you just shake your head in awe. They came up with ideas that I would never have thought plausible or possible, and every one of those revitalized communities is better than it was in its heyday. And when I closed the last page of the book, I was filled with an abiding sense of hope. Because it happened in all of those other communities. Erie is right on the cusp of it, and it's going to happen in Erie. We're going to reinvent ourselves. But the immediate challenge before you and me right now is that we also need to reinvent the church. It is obvious that our leadership has failed us miserably. Our children are not here because the message doesn't make any sense to them. We speak to the world about the dimensions of human sexuality, and we speak in medieval gibberish. It doesn't make sense to anybody. We hang on to formulas that were put together in the 13th and 14th centuries. We don't treat infections the way we did then, or every one of us would be dead. Why are we so afraid of listening to the insights of modern medicine, modern psychology? Of coming to you who live in relationships and know what intimacy is and asking you to teach us? No more. We're tired of this way of doing things. If bishops think they can go back to running the church the way they have been, they're in for a rude awakening because you and I are no longer going to tolerate it. We want a church that is completely transparent. No more secret deals, no more lies, and no more deceit. We want a church that involves women and lay people at the highest levels of decision making. And we want a church that is solely and singularly focused on the gospel of Jesus Christ, that's not worried about protecting its investments, but is welcoming and embracing for everyone, no matter who. That is a church that is forgiving and healing, that we begin to do what Jesus Christ did and not the silliness we have seen in the past. I can assure you that all of these things are in place in our own diocese. Women are involved at the highest level of decision making. Lay people are involved. There is not another bishop in the country who is more transparent than our own Bishop Persico. He is the first bishop in the United States to meet with the SNAP people. These are people, good Christians, who have been going around the country protesting the abuse of children by clergy. And every other bishop closed the drapes and looked the other way. They're cowards, and we do no longer want them as our leadership. And yet I look at the situation, I am as filled with hope about our future as a church as I was when I closed the last page of Our Towns. Amen.